it is day 5 + 3 = 8. Yes, I'm still going. I'm at Custom House. In today's video, as you'll have ascertained from the title, I'm bundling together Custom House and Woolwich and Abbey Wood together. My explore around Custom House starts here at the Newham trackside wall, this piece of artwork by Sonia Boyce that is 2 kilometres long. Do come and read the panel, the plaque here, that it stretches the length of Custom House Station here and beyond. Start with that, an amazing piece of artwork, and then to help me in this video, as we do three station, everyone say hello to James.
Hello.
Who's come to help me. You work where?
I work at City Hall.
At City Hall, so this is your nearest commuter station to go to work.
Yep, this, I get to ride the Elizabeth line every day.
Because City Hall has moved from the Beehive to be in the Crystal down by with the cable car.
Yes, precisely.
And more importantly, I need you for an Oyster card experiment. Did you bring your Oyster card?
I did.
Good man. Hit the button, James. So the DLR station has been here for many years, since the DLR was created. They've tagged onto the side here the Elizabeth line station, but we're not going to be in just yet, because we need to delve straight in to the number one hot topic, and that is how they've integrated the DLR station, which is there, with the Elizabeth line station, which you can, there's a train in right now, which is there. It's here, as the poster says. I'm going to use James here. You've got your Oyster card at the ready, right? Because if you're down on the platforms, we can't go down, because as you can see, both the escalators come up from the DLR platform, and that lets you change here to go on to the new Elizabeth line, where there's a separate gate line. So what's really interesting is that it's not completely integrated, because DLR stations don't have gate lines. They just have
validators.
So you've come up, you're off the DLR, you're walking along, you're following the signs. Oh, hang on. What's going through your head?
I need to tap out.
Hey, yes you do. Because otherwise, what happens next?
I get charged twice, right?
They put the escalators in, and there's a gate line there to enter the Elizabeth line, and a little bit like we had the Oyster validator issue at, did you watch my video? Farringdon, just say Farringdon. Of course you watched it. There's no Oyster validator here either. Could you sort of fake touch in on a validator that doesn't
beep?
I love your beep noise. Just do that.
Beep.
And apparently what was happening in the first week when it first opened, people were coming up and they were being charged a maximum journey because they were just tapping in on the gate line there but weren't tapping out of their DLR journey, and they then had an incomplete journey.
So what they've done, what we think they've done, is they've put a patch on this gate line and this gate line only, which when you tap across will complete the journey you've made from the DLR and then start a new journey on the purple train.
So it doesn't matter that you haven't tapped out with your Oyster on a validator.
We don't think so, no.
As you go through, it will
end one journey and start another.
So it's time to address a couple of things. Is that people have asked, you're so nice, is that this shirt, my purple main shirt with the badge, did get washed a couple of times, so I just haven't worn this straight. I have worn a different purple train shirt every day, link on screen now to buy your purple store merch. Some people have observed that I have indeed got a little bit of white in my hair. That's because when I had the purple streak added for opening day, I had to have it bleached, and the purple has since washed out, but the bleach is still there. Kind of like it though, I might just leave it in. And also, some of you have been observant enough to notice that I've been using my named Oyster wallets for every station, so every video has I've used the correct Oyster wallet for each station. And some of you have been saying, where do you get these from? Well, amusingly, and TfL won't thank me for this, but on the back they all say opening December 2018, because these were given out by TfL/Crossrail at press open days they had back in the summer of 2018, when they thought it was going to open December 2018, and there were 10, and you had to like collect them all for while they're on eBay. But the point is that I've had these saved up, stored at home in a box for 4 years, waiting for this moment, for this week, where I could use these wallets in these videos. You can't get them anymore. I'm sorry, I don't know where to get them from, unless they're on eBay. I don't know.
So the assistance booth here, you can just see there, look, a little bit of purple train maquette on the seat that the member of staff will sit on.
Are you wearing the socks?
My socks. Jeff, very good question.
In the memo very that went question. Out, I specifically said wear the socks.
Unfortunately, on the morning, I was on the first train from Paddington. Yes. On that morning, as I put them on, grip. And there was a massive hole in the back of my socks.
Now
I broke my socks.
Oh, no.
So I wore them on the day with a massive hole in the back of them. they've had to go in the bin, and they went to the Transport Museum a couple of days later to try and pick up a new pair, completely sold out.
The socks are £9 from the Transport Museum.
Gotta buy a new pair, but they're back in stock.
Because they're so popular this week. Ooh. LT Museum shop high have probably sold out of the socks, but you do have
a face mask.
The face mask, but the socks are awesome, right?
So I actually do have Bakerloo instead.
Oh, look at that! Okay, right. Do you want to do lifts and escalators? Let's do that.
Yes.
So the main gate line is here. The other one we saw is on the side. Remember, class 345s have no toilets on board. But James has just found what.
We have an accessible toilet.
Yes.
Right here on the concourse.
Yes.
Yeah.
With a button.
We have a button.
Hit the button.
There we go.
Oh.
It even beeps.
All right.
Accessible toilet.
You have to go in now.
Yeah.
Just, all right. How do you shut the door?
There is a lock button here.
All right. See you later, James. Bye.
Bye, Jeff.
Bye.
Oh, it says touch the lock. And then touch the open. What happened?
There we go.
Oh.
Clear of the doors, please.
Now, we're obviously outside here, daylight as you can see. The rest of the station's in the core, inside, platform screen doors. So Custom House doesn't have any platform screen doors. What you have in the core section with the platform screen doors is, of course, the route map indicator and the next train indicator built into the platform screen doors. With no platform screen doors, that was a lot to squeeze in, wasn't it? They've had to put the next train indicators in a sort of a more standard hanging down, as you would expect. 1, 2, 3, the top one, is embiggened, love that word. I love the fact that next to the time is a little clock symbol, as if to say, like an icon, it's like a graphical interface to denote that what is clearly the time is the time. Train has left. Hi!
Hello.
We're sat sort of at a shelter, which reminds me, obviously you watch all my least used request stop videos.
Yes, obviously.
So I quite often do least used station. I often end up sitting in a shelter with my guest on a bench talking about the least used station. So that kind of feels a bit like that now. And you came up with an extremely astute, right observation, did you not?
Yes.
Go on, tell YouTubes.
So obviously the least used station on the purple train at the minute will have to be Bond Street.
Because
there were zero passengers so far.
Because it's not open.
Because it's not even open yet.
So no one's been through. Now, I'm flashing up a big zero on the screen right now to denote that Bond Street is currently definitely the least used station.
So
what do you think will be the least used station? Might it be Custom House?
I mean, you think that, but then as a regular commuter, I've seen quite a few people coming and going already. So I don't know.
We're at the end. There's nothing here. Yep.
This is the train to Abbey Wood.
James, welcome to Woolwich.
Welcome to Woolwich. It's actually my first time getting out here because I was on the opening train, just came straight through, then came back.
Oh, so you've not been on the platform?
So I've not been on the platform yet.
So you don't know about the coloured things?
No, I don't know about the coloured things. What's the coloured things?
I'll tell you in a second. All right. What do you make of Woolwich?
What was the word used earlier on in the week? Capacious?
That's my word.
Enlarged? I don't know.
Embiggened.
Embiggened.
James, the colours, just going to read from my notes, which I researched, because they're here, you've got red, blue, with a little hint of yellow, and over on the ones over there, it's just red and blue. It simply says, from the Tier 4 website itself, on the platform, a nod to the Royal Engineers and Royal Artillery. So these were obviously the colours, like in their crest or in their design. So it's their colours. Obviously it's Woolwich Arsenal, and these are the Woolwich Arsenal colours. So every alternating pillar is either red, blue and yellow, or just red and blue, all the way down.
The Elizabeth line is running a good service, and there is also a good service on all other lines.
Lift is down there.
Yep.
See at the top.
See at the top.
James?
Yes, Jeff.
It's quite busy.
It is very busy.
That is a fairly constant stream of people.
Which is excellent.
Using Woolwich Station, because all the Woolwich commuters have realised, instead of getting the Southeastern service, which is probably more expensive than the TfL fares,
yes.
Why wouldn't you just get the faster, it's faster and cheaper, to use the purple train?
win-win all round.
Go Woolwich. But sadly, what happened with the lift is now?
So the lift wasn't working when we just went to get it, and so I've had to follow up on the escalators.
Yeah.
There's only one lift.
So unlike at other stations where there's two lifts, just one of them breaks, here one lift kaput today.
Yeah.
I also heard the other day that one of the incline lifts at Liverpool Street also out of action. It's already broken within 2 weeks. But apart from that.
Apart from that.
James?
Yes, Jeff.
Why on the map? Blue, 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 blue. Is Shenfield in black?
That is a very good question.
That is a very good question.
One that we don't know the answer to.
No. Again, if I was doing Secrets of the Liz Line, which I'm not, it would be like, this one is coloured black rather than blue. But then that's really annoying me now. Why is it in black?
No,
all the others are standard TfL blue. TfL, why is Shenfield coloured in black?
Next station, Abbey Wood.
We are stepping out at Abbey Wood. The exit entrance is down that way towards the front. I deliberately want to go the wrong way because I've never crossed over the footbridge. There's like an overbridge, footbridge. Hang on, there's two! Well, I didn't notice it. Hang on, so at the far end, at the western end, there's just steps. Oh, I didn't realise there's two. Well, there you go. I've learned something about Abbey Wood.
Yeah.
So there's two footbridges. The steps only at the far end at the west, but in the middle, there's escalator ones as well. Escalators to take you to the overbridge. Steps this side, obviously. Wide overbridge. Look down onto the two Liz Line platforms there, and then the two South Eastern Line platforms there. So we're back to where I was. It's only 8 videos. It seems like a very, very long time ago that it all started here at 6 a.m. at Abbey Wood. You were here that first day. You got the Paddington.
I was on the Paddington train.
Tell us what happened on the Paddington to Abbey Wood train, James.
So I was in the queue for 5:45. We were sort of held there 45 minutes. I was about 5 or 6 rows deep, and then we got all let down at sort of 20 past. The mayor and Andy Byford sort of leading the way.
You saw them?
Yeah, they were just in the distance.
You're friends with Sadiq anyway. Obviously.
Yeah, I see him in the building every now and again. Yes.
Right.
And so then down to the barriers, and then we had to wait for the one train to go. So it sort of pulls in, and the guy was like, oh, this is the first train. Oh, no, it's not.
And then
actually.
It wasn't. Yeah,
no, it
yeah, wasn't. Yeah.
There was that one then departed, stop. And then right. The next one then came in. And then
so you did make the first train?
Was on the first train, yes.
So you came here to Abbey Wood by about 7 a.m.
Yes.
You just went back again?
Went back to Farringdon, me and my friends grabbed breakfast.
You went to work?
And then I had to go to work.
Oh, that was it. Right, so that was opening day from Paddington to Abbey Wood. I obviously was here from Abbey Wood down to Paddington, and since then I've made videos with, like, a class register, James.
Yes.
You see if I get it right. My thanks to Lewis, right?
Louis.
No, Louis, yeah, I'm doing it. Oh, Reese.
Sorry, yeah.
Sarah, Ian, Keith, and yourself.
Yes, and
yeah, that's all 7. James, that is it. That is the end of looking around all the new Elizabeth Cross, Liz Perp, Rail Cross, Liz, whatever you want to call it, stations.
He's so tired, folks, honestly.
Can I just go home and
yes, now you can.
I'm just gonna, right, press subscribe. Thanks to James. Come ride the train. It's awesome. Thank you. Bye-bye.